So fixing underexposed photos in Lightroom is a challenge, am I right? Plus, when fixing underexposed photos, you end up creating a new huge problem. No worries. Once you complete this Lightroom tutorial, you'll know how to edit your underexposed images properly. So if you're ready, let's do it. So here's one of my favorite images that I recently enlarged, and this was created on one of our many family camping trips to Letchworth State Park in New York. And we've been going now for about 20 years, and there's a lot of waterfalls, a lot of trails to hike, and much more. It's definitely a photographer's paradise. So if you're looking for a new place to shoot some images or looking for a place to camp with family, this is a great place to go. Now on this day, I got up early before sunrise and was presented with my first challenge. Do I expose for the sky or the gorge? And the reason why it was a challenge is because of the large dynamic range of the scene from brightness to dark. So there was a lot of variations in between, and my camera wasn't able to capture all of them at the time I created the photo. So I had to choose on exposing for the highlights or the shadows. Now, since it's easier to bring back detail in the shadows, I exposed for the sky, and that will ensure that I have all the details I need to recover the clouds and the details in the sky. And if we take a look at the histogram here, we can see the histogram right here is showing us that there's detail in the highlights and whites based on these peaks and valleys. So since I exposed for the sky, I now have an underexposed part of my image. Basically, the majority of the image is now underexposed, which is my first editing challenge. So here is the image straight out of camera. And here is the final edit. How awesome is that? So how did I improve the image to be more balanced in the light from the shadows to the highlights and balance the sky and the gorge and the Genesee River and the foreground? Well, let me show you how I did that. Now, since this is a Lightroom tutorial on underexposed images, I'm gonna go ahead and work with this image here, and I'm going to turn on the mask and the edit that I did for the sky. So the sky is done. Now we're just left with the rest of the image. I also have an edit here or a mask for the river as well, which adds a little bit more contrast and depth to the river. I'm going to leave that turned off for now. So as photographers, we're usually taught to increase the exposure or the tonal range that we want to target. So we can do both from the basic panel if you're using Lightroom Classic. If you're using Lightroom, then it has a different panel setup. So in that case, you're going to access the light panel. So these are the settings that I tend to work with first when working on an image. I will target the exposure, highlight shadows, whites and blacks, and then I'll increase my texture and clarity according to my personal preference. So we can increase the exposure to brighten up the gorge and the river, but the problem is it's doing that to the entire image, or it's applying that exposure edit to the entire image. So that's not what I want, because now the sky is becoming overexposed and I'll then have to overcompensate for that when I target just the sky. So the other option is that we're usually taught is to go into the shadows, which is what we want to target, to increase the exposure of just the shadows. So that seems to be doing a better job, but it's creating another problem, actually two problems, and I'll explain one of them now and one in a minute. So if we take a look here, if we zoom into the sky, what happens is when you adjust the shadows, it's affecting the sky as well. So now the sky is darker and now the sky is brighter. So the shadows, even though the tonal range is mostly in the gorge and the river, that tonal range is still in the sky as well. So these edits here are global edits. In other words, it's going to affect your entire image. So I don't necessarily want to edit these parts of the tonal range, or at least within the basic panel. I want to target the gorge and the river separate from the sky. Now, we do have tools in Lightroom that will allow us to do that. It's just not as obvious for certain images like this because we don't really have a background. So if I go into the masking tool here and I try and create a new mask based on Lightroom automagically selecting the background for us, the problem is it can't really determine where the background is for this particular image. And that's because, if I show you real quick, it's targeting more than just the gorge and the river, right? So the reason why Lightroom can't determine where the background is because there's a lot of different layers to this particular image. So we have our foreground. We have a middle ground with the river and this cliff here. And then there's a background behind that cliff, and then we have our skies. Now, real quick, I have a favor to ask, and that is, if you're enjoying this Lightroom tutorial, please show some love by liking this video. So there's multiple layers within this image, and Lightroom can't make a selection for us based on what we want, which is everything but the sky, but there's an easy fix. Let's go ahead and undo that. And once you go in and you create your sky, you're gonna click on Select Sky, and then Lightroom will make that selection for you. And it does a pretty good job for this particular image because there's not a whole lot going on in the sky other than the horizon. There's no trees, there's no branches. So it's a real simple selection process for Lightroom. So I'm gonna undo that because I already have the sky selected down here. And then what we can do is we can click on these three little dots. We get a new menu, and then you want to select Duplicate and Invert Mask. And boom, look at that. How awesome is that? I love it. So now we can target just that part of the image, which is the underexposed area, and we can apply our edits accordingly. So real simple, we can increase the exposure, we can increase the shadows based on our own personal preference. But again, like I mentioned before, there's a new problem when we fix or try and fix underexposed images. So I'm gonna go ahead and undo these. And let's turn off this overlay and let's go ahead and zoom in because I want to show you up close the problems that we create. So this particular image was shot at an ISO of 400, which isn't that high, but it still creates digital noise. So if we take a look at the river, it's easiest to see the digital noise in the river versus this part of the image where it's much darker, but that digital noise is still in there. We just can't see it. So what happens is when you increase your exposure and your shadows or even your blacks, you begin to reveal that digital noise. And of course, higher ISO settings, it's going to look a lot worse. But still, if you don't want that digital noise, you have to try and figure out how to remove it and retain the detail. There's a lot of fine detail in this particular image with all the different colors and the leaves and the branches and the rocks and the river and everything else. And digital noise, when you try to remove it, is going to flatten out that detail. So if you want to learn how to properly remove digital noise, check out the link in the description below. Now we have one small problem with this particular edit so far. When you try and fix an underexposed image and you increase the exposure and the shadows and the blacks, that will lower the contrast. So now we have a very flat image. So I want to add more contrast, and I don't want to use the contrast slider because that's going to be, again, a more global type of effect over the area selected. I want to be more precise in my contrast adjustments. Now, we could use texture, clarity, and dehaze, but my preferred method for increasing the contrast is to use other tools. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the layer mask now, and I like to add a tone curve. So now, just with this particular edit alone, I've increased the contrast of the entire image. Hopefully in the near future, we have the tone curve in with the mask tools and editing tools there. Hopefully that comes soon. Now, I also increased contrast of the colors. This was shot in early to mid-October, and the colors weren't that strong. So I wanted the colors to be a lot more vibrant. And when you increase the hue, saturation, and luminance, you can increase the contrast and boost the colors at the same time. So there's the adjustment I did with HSL. And then the last edit I applied was a small vignette. Now, if you're wondering what the secret ingredients are for fixing overexposed skies, check out this video tutorial right here.